Today we have Mr. Satish from Impartus Innovations, which is a Bangalore-based software firm, and they are working on bringing videos into the mainstream learning process. So welcome, Mr. Satish, sir.
Thank you, sir. Pleasure to be here, sir.
Can you please tell us about your company as such?
Yeah, we are founded this company in about 2013, sir, by a group of IIT and IIM alumnus. Okay, the whole objective is to bring in videos into mainstream learning, sir. And over the past 6 years, we have developed cutting-edge software to enable an institute to automatically record, okay, edit, and then distribute contents.
What are the main product offerings?
Yeah, we have a single flagship product offering which has multiple features to cater to various needs of an institute. Okay, and this what this does is that for the higher education institutes, it enables them to automatically record live lectures.
Can you please share about the main use cases of the product?
Yeah. Broadly, we can demarcate in terms of, like, say, who there are three types of stakeholders is what we look at. Mm-hmm. So one is the management, the second is the professor or the faculty, mm-hmm. and the third is the students. Mm-hmm. So in these three, broadly, if I have to categorize the most important use case for these three typical use cases, for the management, it creates an environment wherein they can maintain delivery standards. Mm-hmm. Okay, not just in a single campus, but if there are multiple campuses also. And the second thing it will also ensure is that automatically create a content library, mm-hmm. okay, which can be used for many other purposes, mm-hmm. going forward. And coming to the students, it takes the learning outside the classroom, mm-hmm. so that a student can engage with a particular concept or a subject, mm-hmm. at their own time and comforts. Mm-hmm. Okay, that is one of the main use case for a student. Mm-hmm. And coming to the faculty, it helps them to do self-learning, mm-hmm. okay, improve their academic delivery patterns, mm-hmm. okay, and then also is that they don't need to repeat a class, mm-hmm. okay, because already the content is available. Mm-hmm. So if somebody has missed a particular lecture, mm-hmm. or if somebody has asked for repeat of mm-hmm. the particular lecture, mm-hmm. so they don't need to repeat the same class once again. Mm-hmm. So the content will always be available for the student to go back and refer to that. Mm-hmm. That is broadly, we can say that for the three stakeholders, this is how it is used, mm-hmm. mostly.
So in order to encourage faculty, yes. so as to use this system,
yeah.
For facilitating their teaching learning process, yes. what are the advantages of this system as far as faculty is concerned?
To broadly add to what we have already discussed, one is that it aids them in creating an online content, mm-hmm. okay, automatically, mm-hmm. so that going forward, once you already have a content with you, mm-hmm. easily you can create an online library, mm-hmm. program out of it. Mm-hmm. Okay, that is one big takeaway from that. And the second thing is that if there are any Q&As recorded, mm-hmm. online Q&As, mm-hmm. that the future batches can refer to. Mm-hmm. So what it helps a faculty is that right now, if I'm able to service about 100 students, mm-hmm. with a technology like this, mm-hmm. faculty can easily increase that service number, mm-hmm. okay, and without any geographical constraints. Mm-hmm. So overall, what it helps is that it helps you to record good lectures and keep track of it. Mm-hmm. And the second thing, if I have to refer to some star faculty lectures, mm-hmm. okay, or some good lectures, mm-hmm. I can learn something out of that. Mm-hmm. So broadly, we can say that it helps in various ways in about how I can improve my own. Mm-hmm. Okay. We are not talking about somebody referring to these videos and giving feedback kind of a stuff. Mm-hmm. It is mostly self. So. Mm-hmm. Because the quantum of videos which get recorded on the platform is humongous. Mm-hmm. So it is mostly the faculties themselves have to go through the videos, mm-hmm. and self-improvement.
Okay. Even I think the faculty from other departments can refer to a faculty of,
yes.
one other department.
Yes.
So the interdisciplinary learning can,
yes, sir.
Can
that also. Is also one of the main thing which is coming up. Mm-hmm. Not just for the faculties, for the students also it is working out, sir. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So interdisciplinary learning can happen and based on their interest.
Yes, sir, based upon their interest. So we have in the application a very simple thing. all the programs will be available for the entire ecosystem. Mm-hmm. If I'm in a particular department, I'll have access to my department videos only. Mm-hmm. But if I wish to explore or learn some other department, I have to just subscribe to that.
Mm-hmm. So that can be done.
Yeah, very easily.
And can it be used to implement a flipped classroom or something like that?
Yes, sir, definitely. Mm-hmm. So one thing is that once you have the content with you and the ability to record a content, so how it becomes is that I can share a certain set of small video or a document or a slide with my users beforehand so that they come prepared for the lecture. Mm-hmm. Okay, and in the actual class, we can have a full exercise or assimilate the knowledge in a much better way. Mm-hmm. So it can be used seamlessly for the flipped classroom also.
Can it be possible, for example, a faculty wants to take a lecture from some of his alumni for whom he has invited,
right, sir,
and he wants to make it live so that everybody at other institutions also can be able to watch that?
Yes,
possible.
Yes, sir, it's possible. Okay. So when we schedule a lecture, sir, it is scheduled on used on a timetable, sir. So what it does is that, say for example, if my timetable is fixed for a particular semester, that entire timetable is uploaded into the system. Okay, and while uploading the timetable, there are various options like only recording or live broadcast and recording. So there are various options which I can select. So if a particular lecture I wanted to be live broadcasted, I will select live broadcast and recording. So you will get a live broadcast link also, and it will record also. So it is not necessary that everybody will have the time to attend the live session. Somebody might be miss it, sir.
Like, so he may be absent or because of some reason.
Or they might miss it.
Right.
So there will always be a recording which they can go back and refer to. So that's how it works.
Sometimes it may happen that because there is a camera fitted in the classroom, the faculty may be like uneasy. It can be possible. Is it possible, first of all?
Yes, sir.
And how the faculty can counteract or...
So, yeah, this is something which we have faced throughout, sir. So the moment a camera is placed in a particular room, sir, it is a human tendency that we get conscious of it, and we might not be the actual natural self. So there is a difference between this and a normal studio recording. Usually in a studio recording, it is a scripted one wherein a faculty talks to a camera, sir. But here it is a live lecture, sir, where there are students in the classroom, where I am interacting with the students. So the thing which we have observed in this scenario is that, sir, after a bit of time, okay, that's about after using it for a week or a 2 or 3 weeks time, okay, it depends on faculty to faculty. After that, the faculty themselves will forget that there is a camera in the room and there's recording going on.
So naturally, they will be able to do it.
Yeah. So the environment is created in such a way that it they will natural environment, because I'm talking to the students, not to a camera. So over a period of time, they even forget that there is a camera. One and two, because this is it gives the actually the publish power is with the faculties. So what I'll be publishing to my students, it's with the power of the faculty. So I can decide what goes to my students. So even if I'm not happy with something which has happened in the lecture, okay, I can remove that portion before publishing it.
If a faculty wants to, say, create an online course or something like that, will this help?
Yes,
for example, I want to, or some other faculty wants to, put the courses, his course in Swayam or any other platform.
Yes, sir.
Is it possible?
Yes, sir. So, as accessibility of this application is done through the Impartus LMS on Google Chrome and Android and iOS app. Okay, but if you wish to publish some of these programs, create a separate program and publish it in YouTube or Swayam or NPTEL network, we give an authority, because the entire content IP is with the institute. The institute can download this on MP4 format, okay, and then do the editing manually, okay, and then can be published in any platform, sir. The whole idea is that over a period of time, the content is already available with the institute. So all it requires is that somebody who has knowledge of the content to sit and edit that portion, which can be put up on Swayam.
Is the editing process complicated? Usually editing is supposed to be complicated.
Yes, sir. So in our system, usually what we provide is it will only enable you to cut certain portions. Mm. But that is on the applications. Mm-hmm. Once you download it and decrypt the video, mm-hmm. okay, it will come out of the application in an MP4 format. Mm-hmm. Okay. Once that is out of it, then you have to use an additional
software. But normally it is not required.
Normally it is not required. As so long as you are
as a common faculty, in order to use any editing software
not
or
required.
Anything,
not
he has to just publish and forget about yeah. that.
As long as the accessibility is on the Impartus application. Mm-hmm. If you want to take it out and create an online learning, sir, mm-hmm. then that manual intervention
yes, that
is,
can be done
yeah,
later.
That will be required.
Okay. But as far as Impartus platform is concerned, that is not required.
Not required.
What are the general like cares to be taken, like wearing a mic or not forgetting? Cares to be taken so that the things go
yes, sir.
Properly.
Yeah. One major thing which we have observed is that, sir, in relating to the mic, mm-hmm. so usually we provide a wireless mic system. Mm-hmm. So all that the faculty have to ensure that it is duly charged beforehand. Mm-hmm. Just like how we charge a mobile phone, mm-hmm. the same similar way it has to be charged. Once the charging is done, they have to wear the dongle mic. Mm-hmm. And then switch it on, sir. Mm.
That's all.
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's easy to use, actually.
Yeah, it's very easy to use, mm-hmm. and that is the only thing the faculty have to do, sir.
Mm-hmm. Suppose a faculty has some extra lecture,
yes,
other than his usual lecture, what
yes.
he should do?
For the scheduling, you're talking about?
For scheduling. Can he access that in his own login and schedule it?
Yes, sir, he can.
Okay. Yeah. So he need not have to write to administrator a mail?
Not required.
Like
not
that.
Required, sir. Only if we have given different options. Mm-hmm. If you have prepared a schedule of a month or a week, mm. you have an option of uploading it as one go into the system. Mm-hmm. Or on a daily basis, you can create your own schedule. Mm-hmm.
But usually that will be taken care by admin. As far as faculty is concerned, he can just wear a mic. Record it and forget about it.
Yes, sir.
And then publish it as and when he wishes to.
As and when he wishes to.
Okay. So that's a kind of simple thing.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
In publishing, how it happens is there is a definite timeline which we provide, sir. Okay. So we usually give a timeline of about 48 hours. So if the faculty thinks that they need to edit something or they want to completely delete it, they have to do it in that time frame. Otherwise, it will publish, auto-publish the entire lecture. So that timetable can, that period can be changed as per your
convenience.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. But by and large, the faculty has he need not to do actually complex editing or something
yeah,
like
nothing,
that.
Sir.
He
nothing.
Is free
yeah,
from that.
Yeah. It is just about cutting some portions.
Okay.
Yeah.
Suppose if it happens that he does some discussion in the classroom.
Right,
as soon as he enters in the classroom, he
right.
does discussion.
Right, sir.
And afterwards, he wears a mic.
Yes, sir.
So what happens in the sense, how can we cut that portion, or is it automatically deleted?
Yeah, so in the system, how it happens is that, sir, if there is no audio, okay, that particular portion, the system actually tags it and puts it separately. So when you refer to that particular video post the lecture for the faculty I'm talking about, so you will get an option of saying that, would you like to publish the entire video or would you like to publish the video where it has audio?
Okay.
So if you click the button of publish the video with audio, automatically wherever there is no audio, it will remove. So you don't have to actually bother about where you want to.
Okay.
And some of the faculty, how they are doing is that, sir, if the lecture is going out of the context, it's but natural, it's a
yes.
live lecture. So we advise the faculty to switch off the audio.
Okay. That's a simple thing that a faculty can do.
Yeah. So if you want to discuss something outside the subject area or anything, any topic outside that, you just switch off the
mic and that portion will be automatically
automatically the system will do it for
do
you.
It.
You don't need to do
that's
it.
Simple.
And once it is done, you can just switch it on, sir.
But that he has to remember that to switch it on.
True, sir. And for that, what we enable is that there will be a light also on that blue light.
Okay.
So once you look at it, you will able to know that whether it is working or not.
Okay, fine.
So we have kept faculty as the core.
And designed
everything around that, sir.
That's
so the whole idea is to make it as user-friendly as possible for the faculty. Because once, if there is no content on the platform, sir, what will the students benefit out of it? So first step is Faculty have to accept and benefit out of the system.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and once the content is on the system, then the students will start engaging, and then it will become a cyclic effect.
Yes, yes, and so, then that will be useful for all the
both,
stakeholders.
Yes, yes, because that engagement will start, online engagement, query handling, documents.
Mm-hmm.
So the learning will start, certain portion of the learning will start going online.
Mm-hmm.
So then the cycle will start.
Mm-hmm. Can you share some success stories or something where the things are properly being used?
Yes,
and
sir.
Those tips can be used useful for our faculty.
Yes, sir, definitely. So we have many institutes in Maharashtra, if I have to take the closer to Sangli is there. Say COEP, it's installed about 3 years now, and COEP is using it to record their important lectures in a particular department, okay, and then share it with their students, okay, and the plan, future plan is also there, is that how to use it to mentor the mentee institutes.
Mm. So this is useful for twinning activities also.
Twinning activities
without
also.
Physically going there.
Not required, sir.
Okay.
Say for example, earlier if you have to do 2 trips in a month with this technology, so maybe you will have to do only 1 trip. I'm not saying that it entirely you will eliminate.
Replace it, but
very
useful.
Very useful in that aspect also.
Mm-hmm.
Because it is just about creating a login ID and sharing the subjects to the particular campus. Mm-hmm.
And not only to twinning institutions, it can go to any institutions with that which we wish to actually collaborate.
Yes, sir. So because the content IP is with the institute.
Mm-hmm.
So it is your prerogative to decide whom you would like to share, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that way it enables you to digitally connect with your ecosystem.
Mm-hmm.
So that it gives you that scale. That's the beauty of the application.
That's actually nice, actually.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
So today we had a good discussion with Mr. Satish of Impartus, and he told us a lot of things about the live recording system which we have installed in our classrooms. Hope that this system, this information or discussion is useful to all the faculty as well as students. And we sincerely thank Mr. Satish for being here and discussing with us.
Thank you. Thank
and
you.
Sharing a lot of things which
thank
are useful
sir.
To us.
Thank you, sir. It's
we hope that he will be again with us sharing some more information.
Definitely.
As per our requirement. And thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.